Hello friends, today I'm going to discuss about Yuzanovich concept under acid based iterations. In my previous video I have already discussed about Arrhenius, Brosted-Lowry and Levi's concept. So in this Yuzanovich concept, it is combination of all these concepts, and Yuzanovich defined acid and bases in more refined way, so it is more acceptable and limitations are less as compared to other concepts. So this Yuzanovich concept is given in 1934, and it is combination of previously given acid base concepts like Arrhenius concept, Brosted-Lowry concept and Levi's concept. According to this concept, acids are those chemical species which can react with base. It can donate the cations or it can accept anions or electrons. So according to Yuzanovich theory, acids are those species which can follow any of these statement, and example of acid is HCl, H2SO4, H+, Ag+, L3+, Fe3+, Ce4+, etc. Now coming to the definition of bases as per this concept. So bases are those chemical species which can react with acids, which can accept the cations, or which can donate or which can give the anions or electrons. So according to this concept, bases are those chemical species which can follow any of this statement, and the example of bases are NaOH, NH3, F-, Cl-, Br-, I-, Fe2+, Ce3+, etc. Now coming to the details of this Yuzanovich concept. So unlike Arrhenius concept, Brosted-Lowry concept or Levi's concept, this concept is much broader and more applicable. So according to this concept, oxidizing agents are acids and reducing agents are bases. So to explain this concept, I am taking the example of an acid, that is Fe3+, and this Fe3+ will accept one electron and it will be converted into Fe2+. So this Fe3+ will act as an acid, this Fe2+ will act as a base. And this Fe3 is known as iron 3 ion or ferric ion, and this Fe2 plus is known as iron 2 ion or ferrous ion. So in this example you can see that Fe3 plus is accepting an electron, that is why it is an acid, because it is written it can accept anions or electron. So this Fe3+ is fulfilling this statement. So according to this statement, Fe3+ is an acid. Now coming to the example of base, and here I am taking the example of Fe2+. So in this example, Fe2 plus acts as a base because it is giving one electron, or it is donating one electron. So Fe2 plus will be converted into Fe3 plus. Ultimately, it is converting from ferrous to ferric. So it is giving one electron, and according to this statement, it can gives or donates anions or electrons. So it is donating one electron. That is why Fe2 plus acts as a base. Similarly, we are taking the example of Ce4 plus. So in this example, you can see that Ce4 plus is accepting one electron, and it is converted into Ce3 plus from ceric to ferrous. That is why Ce4 plus acts as an acid. If we are taking the example of Ce3 plus, then it will give one electron and it will be converted into Ce4 plus electron. So Ce3 plus will act as a base and the Ce4 plus will act as an acid. So similarly, we can categorize acid and bases according to these definitions. Now coming to the nature of the water as per Yusinovich concept. So as per this concept, nature of the water is amphoteric or amphiprotic. So what is amphoteric or amphiprotic? So according to this concept, if water is reacting with an acid, then water will act as a base, and if water is reacting with a base, then water will act as an acid. So in this example, HCl will act as an acid and H2O will act as a base, because HCl will be converted into H plus and Cl minus, and that H plus will be donated to this water, and H plus is a cation. And as per this statement, it can accept cation. This H2O will act as a base. Now coming to the second example, in that example, H2O will act as an acid. So in this example, NH3 will act as a base and H2O will act as an acid, because H2O will be converted into H plus and OH minus ion, and H plus is a cation, and it will be donated to this NH3. So ultimately, H2O or water will be amphoteric or amphiprotic in nature. Now coming to the advantage of this concept. So this concept explains the acid and bases as per cations, as per anions, or as per electrons. So it is applicable in a broader way. That is the main advantage of this concept. In my next video, I will discuss about Lux-Flood concept. Thank you.